So in this video today, we're going to just do a quick video on how to solder in a fuse. We've removed the damaged fuse and we're going to put this replace one in right here. And we're going to flip the board over and show you how to do it. We've gone ahead and put the fuse in place and we've used a piece of tape just to keep it in place. So the solder we're going to be using actually has a rosin core, which means technically we don't need to use flux on the joints. But generally I find it helps to use a little on there, it makes it go a little smoother. So I'm going to go ahead and apply some flux to the joints. And then we can go ahead and take our nice hot soldering iron with a clean tip and touch it to the joint. When you do this, make sure you hit both the pad and the wire at the same time. And we can go ahead and add in our solder on the opposite side. And there it goes. Make sure it's good all the way around. Look, so by adding solder in at the opposite side of the joint, it helps to actually keep the flux from evaporating immediately. And this helps you to make a smooth joint if you're not using extra flux on there. So now we've gone ahead and made our joints, we're just going to take some isopropyl alcohol and in this case a cotton swab and just clean up the joint and get rid of the excess flux. On this kind of board it's not essential, but on other components like tuners it can actually help to remove the flux from around the wires. And there we go, we have a nice clean shiny joint. So when you're done soldering, this is what your joint should look like. It should be smooth, round, and there shouldn't be any gaps, any holes. It should be nice and shiny, and they shouldn't look dull. Here we have examples of bad solder joints. As you can see, they kind of look rough and jagged, then they have bubbles in them. They're not making good connections to the central wire to the component. Over time, with heating, this can cause problems and eventually cause it to crack completely and the joint to totally fail.
Thank you for watching one of our many tutorials here at ShopJimmy.com. We strive to learn and share new TV repair tips every day. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and grow with us. Share our videos with your friends and help us spread the savings.